Hello, welcome to the How Do I video series on Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2015. My name is Arend-Jan Kaufman and I am a MVP for Microsoft Dynamics NAV. I will be presenting how do I set up Office 365 single sign-on in Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2015 using the PowerShell commandlet that is shipped with the product DVD. This video is made in collaboration with Plataan, a Microsoft Dynamics Learning Center from Belgium, and with Microsoft. At the end of this video, we will have a Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2015 environment that is completely configured to use Office 365 single sign-on. The objective of this video is first to know how to prepare the Dynamics NAV environment before the PowerShell script can run. The next objective is to know how the commandlet should be used, what it exactly does, how the commandlet can be started and what the output is. Finally, we learn how to manually add more Office 365 users to Microsoft Dynamics NAV. Before you can start, you need an Office 365 subscription. If you don't have one, you can create a trial account from this address. We have four easy steps. First, we will look at Office 365 and shortly introduce why it is possible to use Office 365 users to log in to Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2015 and how to prepare the environment. The next step is to learn what steps the PowerShell commandlet performs. In the third step, we will actually run the script and have a look at the results. And of course, we are going to test the login and see that everything was set up successfully. In the fourth and final step, we will learn how to manually add new users to Office 365 and connect them to a user in Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2015. Let's start with the first step, the preparation. At first, we have a look at Office 365. Why is it possible to use Office 365 users with Microsoft Dynamics NAV? The reason is that they both can use the same user directory. The Office 365 user directory is in fact a Windows Azure Active Directory. Every Office 365 subscription gets automatically a Microsoft Azure tenant with Windows Azure Active Directory. Each user that you create in Office 365 is actually created in Azure Active Directory. Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2015 can use Windows Azure Active Directory as an identity provider. This is also known as the Access Control Service credential type. As a result, we can say that Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2015 can use Office 365 logins. So Office 365 single sign-on with Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2015 is basically setting up Access Control Service with Azure Active Directory. This can be done manually, but that is an error-prone and cumbersome process. For this reason, Microsoft have provided a PowerShell script that does all the hard work for you. You even don't have to set up a Microsoft Azure subscription to get access to the Azure Active Directory where the Office 365 users are stored in. Before we can set up single sign-on, we need to do some preparation. The PowerShell script requires two components to be installed. If these two components are not installed, the script will fail and you will get an error message with the URL where to download them. Because the Microsoft Dynamics NAV server will be set up to use Access Control Service, it is required to use a certificate to encrypt the communication between client and server. This can be a commercial certificate or a self-signed certificate. To create a self-signed certificate, follow the steps here. In this video, we are using a self-signed certificate that is created with this procedure. Now we are ready with the preparation, we can proceed to step 2, a look into the steps of the PowerShell script. The script performs the configuration changes for the NAV server, the web server instance, and the Office 365 tenant in order to support single sign-on with Office 365. This process is carried out as a sequence of actions. It updates the NAV user with an Office 365 user account. Then it updates the NAV server configuration and the web server configuration to use access control servers. Finally, the script connects to Azure Active Directory and configures it for the NAV web client and Windows client. So all of these steps that you had to do manually before are now performed by this script. Now we have discussed what Office 365 single sign-on is and what the command LET for you can perform. We are going to really execute the script itself. This is the Microsoft Dynamics NAV server that we are going to configure for Office 365 single sign-on. As you can see, this server is currently set up for Windows login. After the script is ready, this will have been changed into access control service to support Office 365 single sign-on. On the product DVD, there are a couple of scripts in the Windows PowerShell scripts folder NAV Office 365 Administration, and here we have the set NAV single sign-on with Office 365.ps1 script that contains the commandlet that is going to be used. As a first thing, we need to open the PowerShell window as administrator. We change the path to the folder where the script is, and we start by import a module NAV Office 365 administration.psm1, which is in this folder. Now we are ready to run the script set NAV single sign-on with Office 365. Of course, this script has a number of parameters. The first parameter is the NAV server instance name. This is the name that we have here, Dynamics NAV 80. The next parameter is the NAV tenant parameter that is being used in a multi-tenant environment. In this environment we have no multi-tenancy, so we will skip this one. The next parameter is a NAV web server instance name. You probably don't know what the NAV web server instance name is. By default, it is Dynamics NAV 80 when you install by default the Dynamics NAV environment. But if you want to know exactly what name of the web server instance you have, you can use the get NAV web server instance commandlet on the NAV 2015 administration shell. This commandlet also gives you the next parameter, which is the NAV web address. This one is the URI address that you can see here. But in this case, we're going to use the local address. In case you are configuring a web client that should be used outside your network, from outside the firewall, then you probably need a public address. Don't forget about the public address here. In this case, we are just using the local address, which is in this address. The next parameter is the NAV user. The NAV user that is in NAV, which is in this case this Windows user, NAV80/VM admin. Then we have the parameter authentication email, which is the Office 365 username. The username that I have set up for this video is called vmadmin@cronuscompany.onmicrosoft.com. Then we have the authentication email password. This is a secure string and we don't want to type it in directly. So I ask to enter this password as first thing when the script runs, and you put it in as a secure string. The next thing we need to use is the NAV server certificate thumbprint. I have used the self-signed certificate, and this certificate is here, and I need to get out the thumbprint of this certificate. You can see the certificate in the details, which is here. But copy paste is not the best way to do this. And on the NAV 80 PowerShell scripts, we have a NAV certificate administration with a get NAV certificate file thumbprint. We're going to use this one to get out the correct thumbprint. Import module NAV certificate administration.psm1, and now we type in get NAV certificate file thumbprint with the parameter for the file path. The file path is this one, copy path, go back, paste here, and here we have the correct thumbprint. Mark it, press enter to copy, go back and paste it. Now this script is almost ready to run. There are some parameters that you can use to skip this configuration of the NAV server, the web server or the Windows client configuration, but this is not what we're going to do now. We are going to set up all the parts. Now we press enter and we type in the password of the Office 365 user. Press enter and the script is starting and you wait for the result. The script is ready, and as you can see here, there are a number of warnings that the new settings value will not take effect until you stop and restart the service. This is because the NAV server has been configured with several new settings, but it has already been restarted for you by the script itself. Let's have a look at the new settings. We refresh, and now we see here that we have an Azure Active Directory App ID URI. This is chosen by the script itself. We have a certificate thumbprint that we have specified. The credential type is set to NAV user password, which makes it possible to have a Windows login that still uses the Windows user and password typed in by the user, combined with a web configuration, web client that uses Office 365 login. Let's now check the web client to see if the Office 365 login has been correctly set up. We open the web client and now we see in the top here, sign in to Azure Active Directory. We type in our username, the password, press enter, wait for a second. And here we are logged in into the web client using an Office 365 login. Let's now do exactly the same with the Windows client. If we now open the Windows client, we get an error message. because the Windows client is still set up for Windows login. We have to change the custom settings.config, which is in the user folder. And in this file, we search for the client services credential type, and we change this one to access control service. That is the first parameter. The second parameter that we need to change is the ACS URI. This ACS URI is available in the output of the script. We mark these two lines, press enter to copy it, and paste the value in this line. Now we save this file, quit, start the Windows client again, and now we have exactly the same login page that we had with the web client. We type in a username and password, press enter, and now the Windows client also starts with the accepted Office 365 login. And here we are, logged in into the Windows client using an Office 365 login. Let's now have a quick look at the users. There is one user in this database, which is the VM admin, and on this user card you can see here the authentication email that we have set up using the script. The authentication status is active, which means that this user has logged in using the authentication email. Proceed to step 4 and add new user to the NAV database and in Office 365 and connect these two. Here you see the Office 365 environment where I have just created a new user called NAV user 1. And here we have the NAV database and we are going to create a new user with the same name. And now in the Office 365 tab we put in the NAV user 1 at kronoscompany.onmicrosoft.com and it gets an authentication status of inactive. It means that this user has never logged in. Press OK and now this user has been created as an Office 365 user. So let's see if we can log in this user into the database. We type in the username and password that we just have created. We press sign in. Now I get a page to change the password. This is because the user has just been created. So I have to change the username and password here for the first time. I press submit. And now we can log in. And here we are as the NAV user 1, just created on Office 365 and connected to a user in this database. And if you open the user card, you can see that the authentication status of this user is now active. In this video, we have learned how to set up Office 365 single sign-on with Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2015. Thanks for watching. I'm looking forward to seeing you again in another episode of the How Do I video series on Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2015.